part of that case there. Now to matters pertaining to the health sector, where the Minister of State for Health, in charge of general duties, Sarah Opendi, has asked Rukungiri District Administration to come up with a bylaw against child and forced marriage. Opendi was officiating at the National Day to End Obstetric Fistula in the district. Banadiga reports from Rukungiri District.
Uganda has today joined the rest of the world to commemorate the International Day to End Obstetric Fistula. At the function held at Nyarushanje Model Primary School in Rukungiri District, the resident district commissioner Dan Kaguta decried the rampant child marriages leading to fistula in the district.
Somewhere here it is normal. Honorable Minister, getting married when you are 14 here it is normal. Some parents even force away those young teenagers. You go and get married.
The State Minister for Health, Sarah Opendi, said the Constitution of Uganda is very clear on child marriage, urging leaders to take action.
That any person below 18 years is a child. However, when this girl is defiled or married off, it is the man who is blamed. But what about the parents who have given out this girl? What about the LOC who could have even attended this marriage ceremony? I come from a district where we had to put a bylaw regarding child marriages. It is now an offense for any child to get married in any village. The LOC one, you will be taken to prison. The parents, you will be taken to prison.
Opendi said fistula has persisted, partly because men have failed on their responsibilities. The UN population body UNFPA reports that Uganda has a backlog of 75,000 fistula cases, an abnormal hole between a woman's birth canal and bladder that causes her to leak urine and feces.
There are new cases happening, and therefore we need to do quite a lot to make sure that we prevent new cases from happening. The good news is that we know what we need to do, and the play has highlighted what we need to do. Let our women go and attend antenatal care. Let them deliver with skilled birth attendants. But Honorable Minister, we also need to tackle the other social determinants. Poverty.
A team of gynecologists and obstetricians who camped at Kisii's hospital have successfully operated 17 fistula patients out of the 30 so far screened. This year's theme, Fistula is a Human Rights Violation, End It Now, is a call to realize the fundamental human rights of all women and girls everywhere, with a special focus on those most left behind, excluded and shunned by society. Bernard Iga, UBC TV, Rukungiri District.